This is a video to show you how to use the rotary evaporator in the laboratory. This is a rotary evaporator which we use to remove solvents at a lower temperature at which they normally boil at. We do this by applying a reduced pressure in the system. There are a few components to this setup. A hot water bath to warm the flask that has the dissolved materials. Since evaporation is an endothermic process, you have to add a little heat to evaporate the solvent. The adapter to connect the round bottom flask to the rotary motor. The adapters comes with joints of various sizes. Here we're using the 1926 neck. The rotary motor to rotate the round bottom flask so that we can dry the solvents at a higher surface area. An aspirator to create vacuum by suction. A cool condenser to condense the vapor solvent from the flask. And a receiver to collect the condensed solvent. The chiller to maintain the temperature in the condenser. Let us follow the procedures. Step 1. Turn on the main switch. Check that the chiller reservoir is filled with isopropanol. Switch on the chiller and maintain the chiller temperature at negative 10 to negative 15 degrees Celsius. Ensure that the aspirator is filled with water. Make sure that the round bottom flask is only half filled and the stirring bar is removed. Before you start to use the rotary evaporator, make sure that the solvent reservoir is empty. Loosen the screw of the clip at the receiver with both hands. Remove the clip while holding the receiver. Use both hands to rotate the receiver out. Turn on the aspirator. Insert a 50 ml beaker filled with acetone into the mouth to clean the instrument. Check that the chiller temperature is maintained at negative 10 degrees Celsius. And you see that the condenser is running. Now, with a right hand holding the round bottom flask in place, turn on the aspirator using the left hand. Gently and slowly switch on the vacuum. Listen for the change in the sound of the evaporator. If the blue indicator is facing down, the vacuum's off. If it is facing you, the vacuum's on. Switch on the rotation and slowly adjust the knob to the speed that you want the flask to rotate. Slowly increase the rotation speed of the rotary motor. Unlock the lever by rotating it anti-clockwise using both hands. Lower the whole setup so that the flask is semi-submerged in the water bath. And then re-lock the lever. After some time, you notice that there's some liquid going down from the condenser into the receiver, and that's your solvent. Here you see some bubbling inside the round bottom flask. It shows that our solvent is vaporizing. After some time, you notice that there are no more solvents inside the round bottom flask. Turn and lift up the lever. Adjust the rotation speed to the lowest. With your right hand holding the rump on the flask, use your left hand, slowly and gently, turn off the vacuum. Switch off the aspirator, and using both hands, slowly rotate the rump of the flask out of the adapter. Next, I'm going to show you how to remove the solid sample from the round bottom flask. You need a flexible metal spatula so that you can bend it and insert it into the round bottom flask. Scrape thoroughly in the inner walls of the round bottom flask to get your solid sample out. After you are done, transfer your sample into a small bag. Here is what you're going to see for a liquid sample. After some time, you notice that there are no more solvents inside the round bottom flask. Turn and lift up the lever. Adjust the rotation speed to the lowest. With your right hand holding the rump on the flask, use your left hand, slowly and gently, turn off the vacuum. Switch off the aspirator, and using both hands, slowly rotate the rump on the flask out of the adapter. I'm going to show you how to transfer a liquid sample from the rump on the flask. Here you need a glass vial, a rubber cap, and a glass pipette. First, attach the rubber cap onto the glass pipette. Insert the glass pipette into the round bottom flask and slowly withdraw the liquid from it. Bring the glass vial close to your pipette. Insert the pipette into the vial and slowly release pressure off the rubber cap onto the upper wall of the glass vial. Repeat this step until all the liquids are removed from the round bottom flask. Secure the cap onto the glass vial, and you're good to go. Now, don't forget to remove the solvent from the receiver and empty it in the correct base bottle. If you recall early on, your solvent are going into the receiver, and the next user may not use the same solvent as you, so it is very important for you to remove it and empty it into the appropriate waste bottle. Loosen the screw of the clip at the receiver with both hands. Remove the clip while holding the receiver. Use both hands to rotate the receiver out. For chlorinated solvents such as methylene chloride, chloroethane, and chloroform, empty them into the yellow label waste bottle. For non-chlorinated solvents such as hexane, ethyl acetate, diethyl ether, ethanol, toluene, acetone, empty them into the white label waste bottle. You will encounter different types of rotary evaporator in the synthetic lab. Please do not hesitate to ask the demonstrator and teaching assistants for guidance.